a very tiny kitchen, so things are spread out, but there's Red Bull and Muscle Milk and Premier Protein, and then I've got all sorts of Trek mix. And each unit is kind of different. Some like the regular Trek mix, some like cashews, others are so health conscious they want unsalted almonds. I've got those too. And then there are other things like Izzy's, and that's it, are great because these pack real easily. My name is Maxine Russell. I'm a retired inner city teacher. I taught in Watts and South Los Angeles and loved it. And the last 10 years or so, I've been a grief counselor, and I donate my time to either the military or other homicide survivors. One of my dear friends, her husband was a Marine pilot, and when he was deployed, I got his address, and that spiraled into a lot more Marines, especially when I moved to Orange County. In April of 2005, he was murdered while teaching English in China, and I remember being in temple, and it was a prayer service for Yom Kippur, and the rabbi was saying, I'm sure those of you who have lost loved ones would rather be with them. And then he added, but if you do that, who's going to keep their memory alive? And it was just like a light went off, and immediately I started thinking of ways I could honor his memory, and because I have so many family members in the military, it seemed like the perfect way to start. So it all kind of came together, and I started sending care packages, and then I became a grief counselor, and I've sent now almost 7,200 packages, so I've had the honor of meeting some incredible men and women. The recognitions are almost hard for me to accept, although people said be gracious, because I really do this because I'm passionate, and I love the military, and I want to show my support. But the albums that I've put together, that really helps a lot, because I think losing any loved one, and you know, unfortunately I've been at some memorials with, you know, with the military as well. You have highs and lows, and when I'm going through a difficult time, sitting and reading the letters and looking at pictures with everybody smiling, or them cooking something, or holding up all the Girl Scout cookies, it just makes me feel good, like I'm making a difference, and then you can't feel sorry for yourself. You have to just get out there and keep trying, and that's what I've done.